Good afternoon. I am representing on behalf of an organization called Directorate of Indigenization, Army. It is a Make in India initiative. Earlier it was initiated in the year 2008, but effectively it has started its work from the year 2010 onwards, but of late 2015-16 onwards, we had a great shift in our working style and the environment. The opportunities which we are going to offer to the industry is being covered in this session. I will be covering it in role organization of my directorate. Progress, what we are tasks we are completed, success stories and major projects and initiatives and other things. The mandate given to us is indigenization of X import origin equipment components, major assemblies and exchange units, other things. Of late, now we have in this year new SOP we had been promulgated. In that we have included product design development also, and platform based and system based indigenization. That means we take one equipment, we make it that equipment to upgraded version of that one in future. Latest equipment also we are taking up. There are four verticals in our organization. Each vertical is looking after one type of equipment. Vehicles is handling tanks and the automotive portion. Electronics and electrical and electronic stores, indigenization committee, we call them indigenization committees, is looking after the electronic component of all systems and the electronic electrical systems separately. Armament stores, which I am being associated with, we are looking after weapon systems starting from your small arms like revolver, pistol onwards till Bofors and now short-term weapon system also. Engineering equipment stores, which is looking after bridge line tanks and other BLTs and other engineering related stores. My organization comes under NGO and under control of DGME. DIIA is being headed by a brigadier officer. He called as a deputy director general, DDG. Indigenization, and there are four verticals as I mentioned. There are vehicles, armament, electronics and engineering equipment. We had been given with the drawings of specification wing, which is the organization which had been assigned with the responsibility to make the drawings by reverse engineering, and any product development or design changes they are going to do, and they are going to freeze the technical specification as well as the drawings. The process involves the stakeholders are customers, line directorates, ordnance depots, engineering sub depots, agencies. We ask for our tender inquiries or proposals on online based open tender inquiry in central public procurement portal run by NIC. That's why we are open to anyone, from small company to defense PSU, ordnance factories. They are all on one platform and they have been treated as a equal. Opportunity is given to all. The regulating authorities are MGO branch, directorate and other IFA, CFA and other things are there. These are the indigenization process involves. I will not dwell upon it, but process is clearly mandated in DPM 2009 under chapter 15, that is design development projects. If anyone interested, they can go through the DPM 2009. As DPP 2016 has been revised, DPM is yet to be revised, but most of this process will not be changing. There will be some enhancement will be there. This is the flow chart. These are the, you can see that as a large quantity of work is involved in armaments. That's what I want to show you. There are 65% of the work is involved with the augment, that is weapon systems, because this weapon system don't have that solution which is commercially off the shelf we can go for. So placement, then quality aspects like pilot sample evaluation, bulk production clearance by samples checking, and inspection note being issued. These are the process involved. Success stories, I'll just cover it, and at the end I'll see where, how you can go into involve yourself and contribute to the nation cause. This is the ARV, Armored Recovery Vehicle VT-72 control set. This has been successfully indigenized by our organization. Track complete Stella 10M. This is the AD weapon system, missile. These are the various item, pilot valve, 40mm L70. In fact, this was made by some Microtech Precision of Hyderabad. The cross engine power in. These are Bofors spare parts, assemblies. These are the electronic PCBs. We are reverse engineering. Major products which are you going to be interested in? Tank T90 track assembly we are planning. RFP will be out quite soon. ICV BMP-2 power pack, which is already it is actually 6-7 factor, 6-7 major companies have been associated with for making it. Its complete engine, transfer gearbox, other system are going to be changed completely. The trials are under evaluation stage. Tunguska weapon track assembly, salt upgraded weapon system, major assemblies, complete assemblies we are going to take up, which is upgrading kit of some gun we are going to take, and complete gun can be made with that of, with the help of these assemblies. These are the opportunities going to come up for you. These are the various hydraulic systems which we are planning to indigenize. I'll just quickly go through it, and where you can find this list, that I'll tell you at the end. Later also you can go through the servo motors, electronic portion. Some of the companies which may be interested in electronic portion, they can go through. Casting and forging facility is required. These are the policy initiative we had taken in this year. Private sector participation is encouraged. Minimum, that economic order quantity we going to calculate for requirement for 5 years minimum, that will be projected. Complex technology, single source, we are going to develop and we are going to declare. If we, there's a one point I want to make, and you please register with you. The indigenization is, we are going to make only very few quantities, and we are going to give 100% design development cost, whatever you ask. If it is there in that competitive bidding, your bid is okay, whatever 100% design development cost will be given to you. And subsequent procurement, we are going to be making on you only, whichever firm which makes the first supply, and we have been mandated to give the order, subsequent orders to them. That 80% for in case second source we are planning to develop, because it's a critical and complex item, 80% of the quantity, subsequent quantity, has to be given to first source. The DIIA 2016 is also giving our various opportunities been given to us. They're increasing our role and the methods. And this, we are not going to ask any registration from you. Various ordnance factories, DPSUs, and other agencies might be asking registration. We won't ask any registration. When you are having registered with DGST, DRDO, we won't charge you EMD. There is no tender fee. Earnest money deposit, we won't ask for from the companies which are already registered with DGST and DRDO. And we are open tender inquiry. Quite transparent and very, very accountable system. I cannot change anything. If I float an RFP or a tender. It is open to the environment and anybody can participate. If you are registered, no EMD has been asked. If you are not registered, please deposit your nominal EMD and participate in tenders. And we going to Abhinesh you. We going to provide you with the drawings required, technical specification. If drawings and technical specifications not there, we'll give you the sample for doing reverse engineering. We're going to be hand-holding you in making the drawings and making the material specifications and everything, technical things. That means we are doing, there is no other agency involved for your quality checking and the other technical things. The procurement of, I already covered it, successful development. New SOP is further making us, strengthening our process, like platform-based indigenization. As I told you, we are looking for VT72 complete platform in future for indigenization. And similarly, GRAD-BM21, which is in under consideration stage, so that we are going to complete indigenization, we are going to plan for that. There is NCNC basis, black box approach, various things are there that I don't want to cover now. The IEC meetings, future meetings which are planned for the equipment. I am leaving this presentation here only. Anybody interested, they can take the schedule of our indigenization subcommittee meetings, where we are going to ask, call for the forms, where they can see which item we want to indigenize for next 1 year or 2 years. And physically they can see, they can study the drawings and they can make their mind and they can participate in open tender inquiry. What I was telling about the list of equipment and the items which can be found in web page, the indianarmy.nac.in is there. There is an organization called Directorate of Indigenization. There is a web page is there, complete details of our organization and what are the assemblies, equipments we are looking for indigenization, that is given detail. These are the list of equipment, what are the items, everything is given in the website. A brief about vendor base, there is a large number of firms already associated with us. There is a scope, there is no end to our scope of work. Anything is there, whatever you want to make, there is no dearth of shortage of orders.